What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Imagine you're creating an app like Zomato, where you collect the menus and all the relevant data of several restaurants and combine them into a single delivery platform. Now your application downloads and collects this data from multiple sources in XML format, and then using those, it displays nice-looking menus, images, and recommendations for the user to pick from. The app you created is now booming, and at some point you decide to enhance it by introducing major UI changes that will drastically improve the user experience. And luckily you found exactly what you need on the market, a third-party library that has all kinds of fancy components along with several crazy customizations. However, there's a catch. This third-party library only works with data in JSON format. Now, you could go ahead and change the library to work with XML, but this might break some existing code that relies on the library. And worse, you might not even have access to the library's source code in the first place, making this approach impossible. Therefore, what we need is kind of an adapter, similar to the one you use between the American and European power plug. This adapter will take all of our XML data and transform it to JSON, making it compatible with the third-party library we are making use of. So, the adapter pattern is a structural design pattern that allows objects with incompatible interfaces to collaborate with one another. Let's try to apply this pattern on the example we just had. So, suppose we have this multi-resto app class along with its interface that take in XML data and that are being used by the UI modules of our app. Also consider that the fancy UI library we mentioned is making use of the fancy UI service class you see in front of you. Now, this class as shown here takes as input a certain JSON data object. Therefore, what we need is a class that will allow us to transform the XML data we have to JSON. To do that, the adapter class we created will use both inheritance and composition principles by extending one of the objects and wrapping the second. Usually, the object extended is the interface of our services, what we need to use or call at the end of the day. And the naming convention used for the adapter goes by the name of the wrapped object. Now, because we implemented the interface of our app, this will allow us to easily interchange both implementations. And inside the adapter's implementation, what we are going to do is convert the XML data we are receiving as input to the JSON data the third-party UI service expects, allowing us to call its respective methods. Now, when you want to make use of this fancy library, all you have to do is treat it as if you were manipulating your original multi-resto app class, and the adapter will take care of the rest. Okay, let's go ahead now and take a look at the structure or class diagram of the adapter design pattern while relating it to the example we just implemented. The first classes you are going to notice are the client and its interface, which were represented by the multi-resto app and iMultiresto app classes. The client houses the implementation of the existing business logic of the program, and the client interface defines the set of behaviors that other classes must follow to be able to collaborate with the client code. Next is the service class, which was represented by the fancy UI service in our previous example. This is usually some third-party or legacy code that the client can't use directly because it has an incompatible interface. Finally, the remaining piece of the diagram is the adapter itself, which was the fancy UI service adapter class in our case. The adapter is a class that's able to work with both the client and the service. It implements the client interface while wrapping the service object. It translates the client calls into something that the wrapped service can understand and make use of. So, to sum up, the adapter design pattern uses inheritance and composition to enable objects with incompatible interfaces to collaborate with one another. To do that, it creates a middle layer class that serves as a translator between your code and the legacy of the third-party class you want to make use of. Additionally, by following the adapter pattern, you will be applying the single responsibility and the open-closed principles, because the adapting behavior is now separated in its own class, and you now have the ability to introduce new types of adapters into the program without breaking the existing client code. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.